The table below shows the scores of a group of students on a 10-point quiz. So we have a frequency table where the first column is the test score, the second column is the frequency of the test score. Remember, the frequency tells us how many times that test score occurred. We're asked to determine the mean score as well as the median score. Let's first find the mean score. To find the mean of a set of data, we sum the data values and divide by the number of values. The mean can also be called the average. Let's first determine the number of data values, or in this case test scores, by summing the frequencies. The sum of the frequency column is equal to 22, so we say n, the number of data values, or test scores, equals 22. And therefore, to find the mean, often labeled x bar, we want to find the sum of all 22 test scores and then divide by 22. We could write out all 22 test scores and then find the sum, or we could also write the sum as a sum of products. What I mean by that is, because 3 has a frequency of 3, we know there are 3 test scores of 3. As a sum, that'd be 3 plus 3 plus 3. But because we have 3 threes, we could also write this sum as 3 times 3. Notice 4 also has a frequency of 3, so we'd have a sum of 3 fours, which we could also write as 3 times 4, or if we wanted 4 times 3. So if we find the product of the frequency and the test score, we can avoid having to write out all 22 test scores. So let's go ahead and do it this way. So again, because 3 has a frequency of 3, we can write the sum of these test scores as 3 times 3, plus 4 also has a frequency of 3, so we can write the sum as 3 times 4, plus 5 has a frequency of 4, so we can write the sum of these test scores as 4 times 5, plus 6 has a frequency of 1, so we could just write 6, or plus 1 times 6, plus 7 has a frequency of 2, we can write that sum as 2 times 7, plus 8 has a frequency of 4, so 4 times 8, plus 9 has a frequency of 2, so we have 2 9s, so 2 times 9, plus finally we have 10 with a frequency of 3, so the sum would be 3 times 10. And now let's go and use the calculator to find the mean or average. So we'll put the numerator in parentheses, so open parenthesis, 3 times 3 is 9, plus 3 times 4 is 12, plus 4 times 5 is 20, plus 1 times 6 is 6, plus 2 times 7, 14, plus 4 times 8 is 32, plus next we have 2 times 9, that's 18, plus finally we have 3 times 10, that's 30. Close parenthesis and divide it by 22. So to one decimal place, the mean is approximately 6.4. And now let's find the median score. For review, the median of a set of data is the value in the middle when the data is in order from least to greatest. So to find the median, we begin by listing the data in order from smallest to largest, or largest to smallest. In our case, this has already been done. If the number of data values n is odd, which is not our case, though I do have an example for this, then the median is the middle data value. This value can be found by rounding n divided by 2 up to the next whole number. If the number of data values is even, which is our case in this example, there is no middle value. We need to find the mean or average of the two middle values, which should be in the position of n divided by 2 and n divided by 2 plus 1. So we need to find the two values in the middle by using these two formulas here. So we need to find the position of n divided by 2 and the position of n divided by 2 plus 1, and then we'll find the mean of these two test scores. Well, because n is equal to 22, here we would have 22 divided by 2, which equals 11, and then here we'd have 22 divided by 2 plus 1, which would be equal to 12. So we need to find the test scores in the 11th and 12th positions, and then find the mean or average of those two test scores. Now, it doesn't matter whether we start from the low test score or the high test score to determine the 11th and 12th position. let's go ahead and start with the low test score, and then we'll use the frequencies to determine the test scores in the 11th and 12th position. So adding the frequencies, 3 plus 3 is 6, plus 4, that would be 10. So the next test score would be the 11th test score, which notice would be 6. So the 11th test score is 6, and notice the 12th test score would be the next test score of 7, so the test score in the 12th position is 7. And therefore the median is going to be the mean of these two test scores, so we'd have 6 plus 7 divided by 2, 13 divided by 2 is equal to 6.5. So the median of our test scores is 6.5. Notice a test score of 6.5 would fall halfway between 6 and 7, or here. And notice how this test score would be in the middle, because there are 11 test scores, looking at the frequencies, below 6.5, and there are also 11 test scores here above 6.5. So half the test scores of 50% are below 6.5, and half the test scores, or 50%, are above 6.5, which verifies our median is correct. I hope you found this helpful.